And here's my solution. I have the value function initialized three-dimensional as lots of 999s. The policy is a similar function in 3D. And then I have a function called policy2D, which is the one I'm later going to print. And that's the same in 2D. Scrolling down, my update function is exactly the same as before for dynamic programming. While change exists, go through all x, y's and all orientations, of which there are four, so it's now a deeper loop. If you found the goal location, then update the value, and if there's an actual update, set change to true, and also mark it as the goal location. Otherwise, if our grid cell is navigable at all, let's go through the three different actions. And here's a tricky part how to make the action work, but it works beautifully. We go through three different actions. When we take the ith action, we add the corresponding orientation change to orientation modulo 4. It's a cyclic buffer. So this might subtract one, keep it the same, or add one to orientation. And then we apply the corresponding new motion model to x and y to obtain x2 and y2. That over here is our model of a car that steers first and then moves. Scrolling down further, if we arrived at a valid grid cell in that it's still inside the grid and is not an obstacle, then like before, we add to the value of this new grid cell plus the cost of the corresponding action. And this is non-uniform depending on what action we pick now. And if this improves over the existing value, we set this value to be the new value and we mark change as true. And we also memorize the action name as before. This is all effectively the same code as we had before when we did dynamic programming in a two-dimensional world. It gets us the value function and it gets us the policy action. However, I printed out a two-dimensional table, not a three-dimensional table. To get to the two-dimensional table, I now need to be sensitive of my initial state. Otherwise, it actually turns out to be undefined. So let me set the initial state to be x, y, and orientation. And all I do now is run the policy. So for the very first state, I copy over the policy from the three-dimensional table into the two-dimensional one, which will be this hash mark over here. And while I haven't reached the goal state quite yet, as indicated by checking for the star in my policy table, now my policy table has a hash mark R and L, but otherwise it's the same as before. If it's hash mark, I just keep orientation the way it is. If it's R, I turn to the right. If it's L, it's turn to the left. I apply my forward motion, and I then update my new x and y coordinates to be the corresponding after the motion, and I update my orientation to be O2. Finally, I copy the three-dimensional symbol for my policy straight into a two-dimensional array, and this is the array that I finally print. The key insight here is to go from the three-dimensional full policy to the two-dimensional array, I had to run the policy, and that's something you would have done to get back this table over here. That's somewhat non-trivial, I didn't tell you this, but I hope you figured it out. But everything else is the same dynamic programming loop that you've seen before.